SB is a 27-year-old female who first presented with joint pain in her ankles and knees and a 115-pound unintentional weight loss. She then moved to Arizona, where her joint pain worsened and she developed hand deformities, sudden sets of rashes, eye swelling, hair thinning, and fevers. By 2020, she became so sick that she presented to the emergency room, where she was found to be anemic, with a hemoglobin of 5 and in acute renal failure. She was also found to be actively hemolyzing. She underwent renal biopsy at that time, which was revealing of class 4 lupus nephritis, and she was subsequently diagnosed with systemic lupus. She was placed on hydroxychloroquine and induced with mycophenolate mofetil. Rituximab was then added to her regimen, which greatly helped her joint pain and her hemolytic anemia. For the next 2 years, she cycled through medications to control her lupus nephritis and arthritis, requiring courses of prednisone to control her flares. In 2022, she expressed a desire to have a baby. She was switched to pregnancy-safe medications, which included azathioprine and tacrolimus with hydroxychloroquine. She remained on rituximab infusions until her third trimester. She was also started on a baby aspirin and daily Lovenox injections. In November of 2023, she had a beautiful baby girl. Unfortunately, after delivery, she developed nephrotic syndrome, spilling more than 4 grams of protein in her urine, with low albumin, hyperlipidemia, and lower extremity swelling. After reviewing her options for treatment, given the refractory nature of her disease, she was screened and enrolled in a trial for CAR T therapy in March of 2024. Here are her lupus manifestations before CAR T therapy. On the left, you can see her malar rash affecting her cheeks, the bridge of her nose. In the middle, you see Jakud arthropathy, which is a type of arthritis that's specific for lupus patients. On the right, you can see her lab values. She was spilling 4.08 grams of protein, the low albumin, anemia, and a very high double-stranded DNA titer. After she completed CAR T therapy about 3 months later, she endorsed less fatigue, less arthralgia and clicking of her joints, and her rash was resolved. You can see her post-CAR T labs on the right. So far, she has now down to 1.4 grams of protein in her urine, a much higher albumin. Her CBC is stable with a stable hemoglobin, and her double-stranded DNA antibody titer is coming down.